द सक्सेस ऑफ एनी बुक डिपेंड्स अपॉन इट्स एबिलिटी एंड द एक्सटेंट टू विच इट कैन कनेक्ट विद इट्स रीडर्स. इन दिस सेंस ऑल दैट रियली मैटर्स इज द पब्लिक ओपिनियन बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली द बुक इज टारगेटेड कीपिंग इन माइंड द कॉमन रीडर. देर हैव बीन डाइवर्स ओपिनियंस अबाउट दिस वेर इन अ सर्टन सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी बिलीव्स दैट क्रिटिकल एक्लेम हैज अ मच मच डीपर इम्पैक्ट ऑन द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द बुक एंड इट दस होल्ड्स tantamount importance which happens to be much more than the common public perception. In the year 2011, the world awakened to the genius of a certain Israeli public intellectual, historian and a professor in the Department of History at the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. His name is Yuval Noah Harari. Based on a series of 20 lectures of an undergraduate world history class which Harari taught at the university, he published his first book in Hebrew in Israel in 2011. This book was later published in English in 2014. From there on, the book has translated into 45 languages as of June 2017, that is till 3 years ago. By now, I am sure you have guessed the name of this book is Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind. The book surveys the history of the humankind from the evolution of the archaic human species in the Stone Age up to the 21st century, focusing on Homo sapiens. In general, the book has gathered mixed reviews and is open to interpretation by many people. Broadly, Harari divides the history of sapiens into four major parts. The cognitive revolution, which started during 70,000 BC when sapiens started developing imagination. The agricultural revolution was the second, which started roughly during the 10,000 BC, coinciding with the development of agriculture. The third was the unification of humankind, signifying the gradual consolidation of human political organizations into one global empire. The last, that is the fourth one, was the scientific revolution, which started roughly during the 1500 BC, wherein the germination of modern scientific outlook was cultivated into the human mind. While it was positively received by the general public, scholars with relevant subject matter expertise have been consistently critical of its scientific claims and the supposed facts used in the book. The primary reason for this could be that many critics cite loss of objectivity as the main reason why one can't take this book seriously, while others state the lack of evidence and the frequent occurrence of Harari's imagination taking the readers to a wondrous but rather misleading and ill-informed place as a grave cause of concern. But one thing is for certain, say what you might about the book, but its commercial success just cannot be missed by anyone. Sapiens made it to the New York Times bestseller list and won the prestigious National Library of China's Wenjin Book Award for the best book published in 2014. The Guardian listed the book as among the 10 best brainy books of the decade, saying that Sapiens had become a publishing phenomenon with wild success, symptomatic of a broader trend towards intelligent, challenging non-fiction books that are several years old. And by the way, you know what? You know you have written a masterpiece when Bill Gates, the man himself, ranked Sapiens among his 10 favorite books of all times. In addition to that, Mark Zuckerberg as well was also quick to recommend it. In conclusion, I would just say that everyone needs to read Sapiens, because Sapiens is not a book. It is an experience in every sense of the word. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your family, friends and acquaintances across different social media platforms. Equally importantly, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel as well. It helps us in staying motivated and creating better quality content on a regular basis. Additionally, in case you have read Sapiens, please do let me know in the comment section, what is that one thing about Sapiens that you really liked what is that one thing about Sapiens that you didn't like that much, and what all other books would you like me to review or just talk about? Yeah, so I hope I see you guys soon. Until then, take care, be safe. Thank you so much. Ta-da.